Two trips.
One week. God, I'm exhausted.
Yeah, I can only say you need a vacation after the vacation. All right.
Yeah. First trip. Brother turning 50.
Hell yeah.
Me and the family went and met in a cabin in North Carolina. Oh, we were right on the border of the Pisgah National Forest.
I'm sorry, the Whatska?
I believe it's called the Pisgah.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
The Pisgah National Forest.
That's right next to the Duty National Forest.
Welcome to Kaka Lake. It's an entire area named by a four-year-old Ric Flair country.
I guess we're about a half hour north of Asheville. 13 of us, dude.
Jeez. 13.
How many is it with, when you're rolling deep with the clan?
Yeah.
What's the most you've gotten up to?
Oh my God. House full. Like, I don't even know. Probably around the same.
It's a lot, but you got your sister who is the field general.
Yeah,
and she takes like the when it comes to like my mom and her two sisters, like. There's no, like, no, here's the thing. They need to step back and, like, let us take point. Let the kids take the point. And my niece is 27. She's an incredible human being. They're old. Like, it's time for you to step back and let, like, the kids take over because there is no one leading the march when it comes to these 13 people. It's like, oh, my, I just step back.
You get a little taste of my house on the weekend.
Oh my God!
That's 17 people. That's 17 people in my home.
Really?
All of them I love.
Yeah, but you're not going.
We're going nowhere. We're in my home.
Oh,
you're
dude.
Traveling.
When you're like, hey, we're in a cabin. Out. And like, all right, when it comes to like cooking, fine. The women, like, I ain't got to do a damn thing.
Women.
The mom and my aunts are all, it was my mom, her big sister, her little sister, my Uncle Nick, my Uncle Jerry, my Uncle Mike, Carol.
It's freshening me up.
It was everyone. But then when you're trying to like go around town and you're trying to sight, like that's why your sister types up that whole thing.
Oh,
with,
oh
like,
yeah, that's the one in Canada. I thought you meant the one
well,
in New York.
Well, it's either one. It seems like they both have like, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
And you almost need it.
Yeah. This is what we're doing. This is where we're going. This is when we're leaving. This is when we're arriving.
Dude, we're walking around Asheville. We couldn't go into one store just to go like shoppers unless we had all 13 people.
Yeah.
It's like, where's Angie? Where's this? It's like, dude, we're just going into a store. Like, they're not going to, like, fall off the face. You need the whole group at all times. It was like.
On the count of three,
oh
let's get ice
God.
Cream.
Yeah, it was, whatever. It was nice. Asheville's cool.
Where'd you stay?
We were in a cabin. A cabin with, like, 13 people. My dad, we sang him happy birthday. I guess my aunt, it was her birthday.
How's Pops getting around?
Not great.
Cause I know Disney, just for comfort, so much walking, you do 10 miles a day. He needed to be pushed, but he walks around.
Oh, dude, that was another thing. And it's not on my, I'm not going to put it on my niece cause she's incredible. But, we did go, she's got a map of all the waterfalls in North Carolina and her and her, husband like to go like, camping and they'll sleep in tents. They'll do the whole thing. And then
they
go on hikes. And she had like this cool paper map that she laid out that had all of the waterfalls. And we found one that was only like, I don't know, a half hour away, hour away or something.
Yeah.
Half the road was a dirt road, which was crazy. And it was up the side of a mountain. And then the trail, which I guess was listed on the internet as being whatever, like level easy.
Yes.
Was not what it was. Not easy.
A North Carolina easy.
It was flat, but it was very rocky and very tree rooty and very. Yeah. And then my dad, here he is, 80 with two forms of cancer, a bad hip, trying to navigate this thing. My mom, my Uncle Jerry, he's got some sort of cancer or something. He had to turn around and go back. It was dicey.
Treacherous.
Dude, it was half a mile, maybe a little more. Half a mile hike should take you about 20 minutes. No, a mile if you're hiking usually takes about 20 minutes. This should have taken 10, 15 minutes. We were out there for 45 minutes.
Oh my God. Just so how many
ways?
13 people at the base. How many people made it to the top?
All but three.
Okay. All right. That's a decent clip. So some people holding down the fort while you guys are at the top of the...
Well, my brother turned around with my Aunt Angie and Uncle Jerry.
Oh, that was sweet.
And went back to the car.
I did that in Hawaii so many years ago, 9 years ago, the first trip to Hawaii with Mudge. Not on the trail. For whatever reason, I thought I could just read the topography of the land. And I said, I bet that trail leads to the top of that waterfall. And 4 hours later, I had a pregnant woman lost in the jungle when two German tourists walked in the opposite direction going, you guys, boys, used to turn around, the trail is treacherous. And the sun was setting, and I didn't need to be in the jungle with a pregnant lady. So we did that, and she didn't speak to me for a day. So you guys, you get back down. You're getting, what are you doing at night in the hotel? Not hotel, excuse me, cabin.
A lot of board games. Mm-hmm. There's a game called Rummy Cube, I guess, that they were playing.
This was the place with the hot tub?
Cards Against Humanity. There was a hot tub. There was a lake. We were fishing. We
you
were in the hot
cards
tub.
Cards Against Humanity with mom and dad?
My dad, my daughter.
Oh,
she's
no.
11.
Jesus.
Dude, I'm sitting there and I heard
that part
this
of your body.
To this.
To, oh!
This to this.
That's whoa. Another reason to play the ATM song.
And I was like, I'm just sitting back going, oh, boy.
No. I know
boy.
There's a card
Let's
that
hope
says,
that one goes over her head.
There's a card that says Hitler's penis. I know there's a card.
I was like, I'm just going to let it happen. Whatever. She was with my niece. My niece is great.
Okay.
And, they kind of, but I do have a list, if you would.
Okay, please.
This is a list of things, including but not limited to, that my mom worried about on the trip to North Carolina.
Sweet Rita.
Dog eating a strawberry. Falling off a cliff.
Your dog eating a strawberry.
No, my brother's dog.
Okay.
A strawberry fell on the floor, and my mom freaked out. And then my sister-in-law goes, oh, no, I gave that to him as a treat. That's fine. Meanwhile, my mom thinks the dog's about to die.
He's going
to
die.
Dog eating a strawberry, falling off of a cliff.
Okay.
Car falling off of a cliff. Stella going missing. This was a big one.
Why would she go missing?
Stella was literally laying on the floor right next to me. She goes, dude, if I had a dollar every time, she goes, where's Stella? Where's Stella? Where's Stella? All weekend. And she's laying right next to me on
the
floor.
She's right there.
And I go, I don't know. I haven't seen her.
I don't know. I got
where
no idea.
Oh, my God. Where is she? I go, I don't know. I haven't seen her.
Where's she
starts to, like, panic.
I'm
like,
I have to find her.
Where is she going to go? And meanwhile, she's right here. And I'm just gaslit my mom all weekend.
I've been looking for her, and I can't. But really, she's, like, rocking in your lap. I don't know where she is.
Ticks. Dude, when we went on the hike, they have, like, those little, like, you know, like, those stretchy, like, bands now. But they have, like, the tick.
Repellent?
Repellent, like,
yeah,
on
yeah,
them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We have the cordage ones for flies and stuff.
Yes,
yeah,
exactly.
Cords. Yeah, yeah.
Dude, she... I think she made everyone have both wrists and both ankles.
Yeah, like gauntlets. They went all the way up to the
ticks.
Elbow.
Getting poison ivy on their butts.
Okay, okay.
Not having a flashlight to see incoming invaders.
Incoming invaders? Like, we're going to get attacked by South Carolina?
A car coming down the road and turning into our driveway. Leaving the rind on the watermelon instead of cutting it into cubes.
Oh, my God.
Running out of room in the trash cans. This was a big one.
Okay,
Do you have room in the trash cans? Not having all 13 people together when we went into a store.
Okay.
The storm. Delayed flights. Canceled flights. A dropped potato chip. Losing someone in the city of Asheville. My Aunt Angie going to the ATM. Walking down the wrong street. And finally, my brother falling asleep and drowning in the hot tub.
Oh, no. Pulling a Matthew Perry? Jeez. No.
That was a legitimate fear of hers.
Mom thought.
Yes.
Your brother, who I've met on many occasions, upright, sound body and mind. A man that, on a list of 100 people that would drown in a hot tub, he ain't on that list. And she's thinking,
I mean,
he's going to slip beneath the waves.
Legitimate fear. Like, we are all sitting around the campfire. She goes, where's Christopher? Where's Christopher? We go, he's in the hot tub. He got up and he's like, I'm going to go into the... I'm going to sit in the hot tub for 10 minutes. And we're all like, okay.
Okay.
Did somebody check on him? I go, what is... I go, he's in the hot tub! What if he falls asleep and... She literally thought he might fall asleep, which I guess maybe is a possibility.
I mean, if you've ever hung out with Eric Woodworth in Deep Creek, I once had to...
My brother does not drink.
I had to take my pants off to get him out of the hot tub.
I don't think my brother's ever had a drop of alcohol in his life. He does not do drugs, hard drugs, no illicit drugs, no recreational. He is a sober man.
He's the least
likely
to drown.
Is he of a little bit of a larger carriage? Yes. He had his iPad in there. He was watching a TV show, relaxing in a hot tub.
That's
my mom...
Huh?
could not sit there. She had to get up and walk over and make sure he had not fallen asleep and drowned.
God. That is dark, man.
And I wonder why I'm now on 10 milligrams of Lexapro.
Why you need some sort of calming pharmaceutical. Oh, she cares because she loves. All right, coming up. Nick Testoni in sports and the second half of the trip. This is the one I was excited for. You've always got tales to tell. You and the boys get together and you head some destination unknown. There's drinks, there's missing dudes, there's hilarity at bars. Occasionally there's winks towards the fairer sex. Let's find out what happened with the second half of the trip with the boys after sports. So, when we last joined you, Scott, you wrapped up the North Carolina trip with the family.
Oh, I forgot to tell you, I got delayed.
Saw the sheet of...
Dude, my aunt and uncle and their flight got canceled. I had a minivan all weekend, by the way, and I kind of loved it. I kind of loved the minivan.
It's convenient.
I was in charge of, like, shepherding everyone around with my minivan that we rented. And on the day we were leaving, I had to drop my aunt, uncle, and my other uncle off at a hotel because their flight to New York was just canceled, and they had to go the next day. Meanwhile, mine gets canceled. Mine gets rerouted, canceled, rerouted, this thing, bang, bang, boom, boom, the other thing. I flew American. I'll tell you what, they were great, though, because I had, like, the text alerts.
Yeah, yeah.
And they say, your flight has been delayed. Your flight is back on time. Your flight has been delayed. Your flight has been canceled. We're working to rebook you on a new flight. And, like...
In real-time updates, you just sat there and read it.
I didn't really have to do anything. And then they're like, we're rebooking you on a new flight. And I'm like, okay, let me see how this goes. Boom, I got another text. You're rebooked on a new flight. And
still
here's
sucks
your
to get it canceled, but a convenient way to go about
so
it.
So then anyway, like, we were delayed all the way until probably, like, I don't know... late at night, and then they flew us into D.C. They're like, the closest we can get you is D.C.
Reagan.
I flew into Reagan, and then Stella and I had to take an hour-long Uber ride home.
Sucks.
So we didn't get home till like 2:33 in the morning on Wednesday.
You want to appreciate BWI a little bit more? Spend the day at Reagan.
So I was home Wednesday. Thursday, flew back out. Up north this time to New Hampshire.
Hell yeah.
The lakes region of New Hampshire. Lake Winnipesaukee.
Whoa.
Like Winnipesaukee.
The good land.
A little town called Laconia, Weirs Beach. And me and my friends from home, we do it every year. We get together. We had no idea what to expect. My one buddy from home, from Long Island, now lives in Maine.
Yeah.
So he's kind of familiar with the area. But total crapshoot. Ended up being a blast.
Okay,
it was
what do you
so
think I'm gonna
fun.
Ask? We talked about this before you left. Did you go to the Fun Spot Arcade?
No.
Oh, the world's largest arcade.
I didn't even know where the hell it was.
Yeah.
We should have went. Why didn't we go?
It's huge. Okay, so where did you go?
One day we golfed in the rain. I left my big water bottle that I always bring in here.
Mm-hmm.
I left it at the golf course.
Oh no.
I called multiple times to see if they found it, and they claim they didn't. Which I think someone stole it.
As you hear him take a large sip of
water.
Yes,
exactly. So I lost my damn water bottle.
Oh, no.
eBay.
We golfed one day. One day we actually rented a boat and went out onto Lake Winnipesaukee. Spent the day on the lake.
Question about that. So when you rent a boat, does someone have to prove they have a boating license? Or there's like, you look trustworthy.
Dude, it was a pontoon boat. I think they'll rent anyone a pontoon boat. Pretty much.
Yeah.
My one buddy he owns a boat, so he knows what he's doing.
I love pontoon boats. It's a living room on the water. Pontoon boats rule.
The engine, I think, had like 25 something horsepower.
Yeah.
Are they horsepower?
Yeah, and some outboard motor.
You could not.
Putts around.
Oh my God.
It's the golf cart of the seas.
But so I guess like this, it's called the Lakes region. There's Laconia, which is a really nice town. Then like just north of it is Meredith, which is also really nice. But it's about an hour and a half north of Boston. So a lot of people go up there for the weekend hang out. And it was a lot of New Englanders. Dude, that accent the Boston accent's a little like rough, but the further you get up into New England, the accent is so incredible.
Really?
It's so,
did you hear that accent come out of a good looking lady? Like
yes.
Then you look over, she's a nine,
yes.
Then she kicks that barf into gear and you're like, whoa. Or is it hotter?
I was hotter.
Really?
No, I loved it. And the Boston, they're just, it's...
You got a wicked big crank on you.
Yeah, it's that, like, Northeast sensibility where they just, you know...
Put your hands down my
pants.
You're
never going to offend anyone. They'll probably offend you, and you offend them back, and everyone... It was just so much fun. It was me and all my buddies had just a great time.
My one buddy, any issues at all? Did anybody get out of pocket?
It was funny, though, because my buddy just went to Hawaii, and I guess he stayed in Kauai. And while he was in Kauai, I guess a lot of, like, celebrities and NFL players there, he got mistaken for Drew Bledsoe twice.
Really?
In Hawaii. Okay. So we ran it back at the guys' trip in Laconia, and we're at this one bar. And, I mean, this is it's like a beach bar, and it's like it's awesome. There's sand, and everyone's, like, hanging out drinking after a day at the lake, and they're all Boston people, and they're all loud and obnoxious. And we had – these girls were – I mean, my buddy was taking photos as Drew Bledsoe.
And he just went with
it. I think he signed autographs.
I get to be Drew Bledsoe this weekend.
And he looks just like Drew Bledsoe. Yeah, it's incredible.
Hysterical. Good for him. Kawhi meaning lovable.
But, yeah, it was – I don't know. I don't know what else to say.
The guy's vacation sounds like it might have been – it's obviously getting a little bit smoother, less people, everybody capable – on the boat, probably get into the bottles a little bit more than you can with the fam.
Yeah, we just did not expect this trip to be fun. It ended up being really fun. There's Tower Hill Tavern, which was a lot of fun. The Big House was really fun. I stayed an extra day with my buddy because he had the cabin, so I was like, why not? Let's just stay. We spent the day together on Sunday. You can see those photos. We did like an impromptu photo shoot with all
it
around town
cute.
With him.
And, it was very cute. Did you stop at any of the islands on the lake? Because I see it's like it's peppered with islands.
Yeah, it's a crazy looking lake, man.
Yeah, it's got a
Bear Island, Cow Island, Backland, Governor's Island,
Snake Island, which is covered in rattlesnakes.
Dude, it's crazy up there. You got to go to the Northeast. It's so cool.
People sleep on New Hampshire. I've been to New Hampshire once on the way to Burlington and stopped for the night and had a fine time. Well, good. I'm glad no one is worse for the wear, and I'm never getting in a hot tub again.